Good morning, dear saints. It's good to be with you again today. This is Vicar Dennis, Divine Shepherd Lutheran in Black Hawk. Today we are looking at, this is your devotion for December 8th, and we will be reading, our Old Testament reading is from Isaiah chapter 24, about halfway through chapter 25. Our psalm for today is Psalm 11. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning I prepare a sacrifice for you and watch. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In the Lord I take refuge. How can you say to my soul, flee like a bird to your mountain? For behold, the wicked bend the bow. They have fitted their arrow to the string to shoot in the dark at the upright in heart. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes see, his eyelids test the children of man. The Lord tests the righteous, but his soul hates the wicked and the one who loves violence. Let him rain coals on the wicked. Fire and sulfur and a scorching wind shall be the portion of their cup. For the Lord is righteous. He loves righteous deeds. The upright shall behold his face. Amen. All right, our reading from Isaiah, as I said, we're looking at Isaiah chapter 24, beginning at verse 14. We read, they lift up their voices, they sing for joy. Over the majesty of the Lord they shout from the west. Therefore in the east give glory to the Lord, in the coastlands of the sea. Give glory to the name of the Lord, the God of Israel. From the ends of the earth we hear songs of praise, of glory to the righteous one. But I say, I waste away, woe is me. For the traitors have been betrayed, with betrayal the traitors have betrayed. Terror and the pit and the snare are upon you, O inhabitant of the earth. He who flees at the sound of the terror shall fall into the pit. And he who climbs out of the pit shall be caught in the snare. For the windows of heaven are opened, and the foundations of the earth tremble. The earth is utterly broken. The earth is split apart. The earth is violently shaken. The earth staggers like a drunken man. It sways like a hut. Its transgression lies heavy upon it, and it falls and will not rise again. On that day the Lord will punish the host of heaven in heaven, and the kings of the earth on the earth. They will be gathered together as prisoners in a pit. They will be shut up in a prison, and after many days they will be punished. Then the moon will be confounded and the sun ashamed, for the Lord of hosts reigns on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, and his glory will be before his elders. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you, I will praise your name, for you have done wonderful things, plans formed of old, faithful and sure. For you have made the city a heap, the fortified a city of ruin. The foreigner's place is a city no more, it will never be rebuilt. Therefore strong peoples will glorify you, cities of ruthless nations will fear you. For you have been a stronghold to the poor, a stronghold to the needy in his distress, a shelter from the storm and a shade from the heat. For the breath of the ruthless is like a storm against a wall, like heat in a dry place. You subdue the noise of the foreigners as heat by the shade of a cloud, so the song of the ruthless is put down. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will make all, for all peoples, a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain, and Moab shall be trampled down in his place, as straw is trampled down in a dunghill. And he will spread out his hands in the midst of it, as a swimmer spreads his hands out to swim. But the Lord will lay low his pompous pride together with the skills of his hands, and the high fortifications of his walls he will bring down, lay low and cast to the ground, to the dust." Well, dear friends, these are great words here this morning. Starting here in chapter 24, the remnant, the ones that we read about earlier, these ones that we're going to, as judgment comes up on the earth, up on the earth, and the remnant, they now rejoice. As we talked about yesterday, we are God's people. We belong to him. This judgment, and we have been judged. We don't have to fear when we see these things, and for we know what's going to be the demise of impenitent sinners, those that reject Christ and reject his word, reject his Holy Spirit. But we belong to Christ, and we have this wonderful promise here. This is has echoes of it in Revelation, does it not? He says here, "He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken." The Lord has spoken. His word will never fade away. The earth, the kingdoms, everything will fall away, but his word will remain forever. That same word, my friends, that speaks words of life to you and I, that called us as his own, that washed us in the waters of our baptism, where we know that we belong to him. And because of that, he has swallowed up the death that you and I deserve. He has swallowed that up there in his grave. And so because of Christ dying and rising again for you and I, so then we have that promise and assurance of eternal life and a life unto in a resurrected life for eternity. How amazing and how fantastic that is to think about. So, one last thought here in verse 23 of Isaiah chapter 24, where it says, "The moon will be confounded and the sun ashamed, for the Lord of hosts reigns on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, and his glory will be before his elders." Again, if we look at Revelation chapter 21, I believe it is, where it talks about the new heavens and the earth, new earth, and the sun, the stars, all those things, we will no longer have that light. We will not know that sort of light because of God, because of his reign and his glory will be shining forth over all the earth. What a great day that's going to be. So these are great words here for us in Isaiah today, and I hope that thus far this has been a blessing for you. I would just encourage you to stay in God's Word, stay in it daily. As we know that His words, His very words, is where we receive the life, we receive the assurance, His promises that He has for us, and it's here in His Word, and it's through the receiving of His holy body and blood that we are assured and that we know that He is with us, even in this place, in this dark and dismal world in which we still live. Well, let's continue as we profess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I thank You, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, Your dear Son, that You have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that You would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings and life may please You. For into Your hands I commend myself, my body and soul, and all things. Let Your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, it's been good to be with you again today. Please keep tuning in. We'll keep walking through Isaiah here right now, and I will see you again on tomorrow on the 9th. God's peace be with you today.